गुड आफ्टरनून वन एंड ऑल. टुडेज सब्जेक्ट मैटर फॉर डिस्कशन इज द फर्स्ट अमेंडमेंट ऑफ यूएस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. एज यू नो द आफ्टर द कंप्लीशन एंड फ्रेमिंग of United States of American Constitution, which is a written document and is a successful document. There was the need to amend the American Constitution, and the draft of the amendment has prepared by James Madison. And for the purpose of media and law, the first amendment of the USA, United States of America, is a relevant document. Therefore, there are some queries. What are the provisions for press under the first amendment of the Constitution? This is the first one. The second query says that whether there are some exceptions as imposed on the free speech and expression. Speech and expression. Video is on. My voice is audible. Whether there is any problem relating to the voice?
No, sir. You are audible, sir.
Okay. Some student is sending the WhatsApp continuously, the video. Okay. Now, there are some questions relating to this first amendment of the United States of American Constitution. As you know, that whether there are any exceptions as prescribed under some written constitutions like India also, 19-2. This is the query. Third is that whether there is any other provisions relating to the application of sedition in the matters of speech and expression through the press. And fourth is, what are the judgments of the Supreme Court of United Nations of America, United States of America, related to the regulating related to regulate and prohibit impose some restriction on the free press. These are the basic queries, and one by one we will see the answer of the queries. And first of all, it requires to know the basic and fundamental principles of first amendment of the American Constitution. If you will see that the first amendment of the American Constitution says that the Congress shall not make law to limit the freedom of speech and expression. This is the first one. The first provision, because it requires to divide into the segments. And if it will be divided into the segment or into the facets, elements, and that is one of the called the integrants of the First Amendment of United States of America. The first point is, Congress have no power to make any restriction on the freedom of speech. There is no power of the Congress. Congress means the appropriate legislature, just like the in India or in UK, there is a parliament. And in the same way, the federal legislation of the United States of America is called the Congress. Number two, integrants and the segment is freedom of speech is the liberty to speak without fear of the restraint. Any kind of restraint means the restriction, any kind of limitation cannot be imposed by the government of the United States of America. This is the second part of the First Amendment of the USA Constitution. First part is no law shall be made. Second part said that no restrictions shall be imposed on the free speech and expression. And third, integrants of this amendment first says that freedom of speech is closely related to, that is closely related to the that part which says that the freedom of speech is closely linked with freedom of press. This is the the useful provision of the First Amendment of USA Constitution, which relate to the law and media as a subject matter of LLM second semester course. The third point. First point, the law cannot be made and shall not be made by the Congress. The second, the government shall not impose any restriction on free speech and expression. There are some difference between point number one and point number two. Point number one says that the law shall not be made. This is the direction or the mandate, constitutional mandate under the USA Constitution to the legislature, that no law shall be made by the Congress of the United States of America to impose any restriction on the free speech and expression. Second point says that the state shall not impose any restriction on the free speech and expression. One side, the legislature, first point, and second point is the constitutional mandate to the state. State means executive. It says state includes the legislature also, but here the indication of the framing of Constitution of USA is to the executive, that the executive shall not have any power to impose any restriction on the free speech and expression. This is clear. But the third point says that freedom of speech is closely linked with the freedom of press. The word used, closely linked with, it means the freedom of press categorically has not been given as a right to access it by the people of United States of America. But it has written that it is closely linked with. It means it is an integrated part or integral part of the speech and expression. It is one of the facet. It is one of the basic, the element of the speech and expression. Press is the closely linked with. The meaning is thereby that it is linked. If it is linked, it can be separated, but it comes from the speech and expression. And it is a part of, integral part of, a united part of the speech and expression. Therefore, the press, freedom of press is closely linked with the speech and expression. This is the third point. Because the whole amendment is together, they have not segregated it. They have not made the separate, but it requires to make the separate for the purpose of the study. And if you will separate it by point wise, then you will get the very easily the analysis of the First Amendment. The fourth says that, fourth point, as it is not a point written there, but for the purpose of study, I have separated this one. Fourth says that right to speech and right to be heard. It means one side, that is the speak. Another side, the freedom of speech. Speech, speak. Expression, press. These are the words. Speech, expression, press, speak, and the heard. These are the five words. One is speech, another is expression, third is press, and fourth is speak, and fifth is be heard. These are the words used by the framing of the American Constitution. And this is guaranteed by incorporating in the Constitution by the First Amendment of the Constitution. It comes, it is not a word in Indian Constitution. If you will see the Article 19.1a, there is a word only, the citizen shall have the right to speech and expression, A. Only these are the words, only two words are there. But in American Constitution, there are the five words which comes under the speech and expression. The fifth point says that the freedom of speech and freedom of press, commonly called freedom of expression. Again, in one point, the amendment of the American Constitution says that the press is closely linked with the speech and expression. But in another place, it says that the freedom of speech and freedom of press, speech and press, both commonly called the freedom of expression. It means it is a explanation indirectly, but explanation word is not written there. Explanation, normally, if there is any requirement and need to clarify any provision, there normally there is a provision after this section or as a part of the section, as a part of the article, that explanation illustration you might be seen because you have crossed one UG degree. And but here is no explanation. But indirectly, if you will analyze the provisions as given under the United States of American Constitution, that they say that they have clarified it, the what is the meaning of expression, what includes the expression, and expression only to indication, expression is only to express the body language or something else. They said that the speech and the press commonly called freedom of expression. The meaning is there by that. If one will speak, there is some difference. Speak and speech. And speak to say something. I am speaking just now. Speech, a common for the purpose of the common lecture, which is called the speech of a person, speech of a leader. Speak in between two persons for a temporary period or for the long period, or means the duration may be the long or duration may be the 1 second, 1 minute. That is speak. I have spoken. X is speaking, but speech, whenever the word will be there, the speech, it means it is a length, it is a very big duration of the speech. And in the short word, or in a summary, one can say that the speech have the long duration and speak have the limited. In speech, there may be the audience all, but in speak, only two persons will be A and B in between the speaking will be in between two. But it is a lecture to deliver to the students. They are the audience. They are the one more than one. It means it is a speech. And categorically, the American Constitution has used the word speech, expression, heard, press, and they have used the word that five words they have used. One is the speech, another is the expression, third is the press, fourth is the speech, expression, press, third, team, and fourth is speak, and fifth is heard. Categorically, very clear demarcation in between the words they have used in their constitution. But this is indirectly comes within the speech and expression. Therefore, they said that one side, one in one place, they said that the press is closely linked with the freedom of speech, closely linked with the freedom of speech. In another place, it has said that the speech and the press both are commonly known and called the freedom of expression. What is the meaning of these words? So that always I have given the emphasis, whenever we are studying, X is studying, Y is studying, please don't be hurry in study. Only one provision takes much time to understand it. And once the habit of the reader who is studying will develop to understand the law by searching the meaning of the words as used in a particular place of law, he and she will be in position in future to understand quickly the provisions of law, and automatically it will come in the memory. Automatically it will come into memory. There is no need to retain, to try to remember again and again, but it will get the place in the memory automatically because we have tried to understood it. Therefore, the American First Amendment says that there are the words, and these words are with relate to the law, with relate to the not to impose any restriction by the executive, and with relate to the law cannot be made by the Congress of USA, which is related to the speech, which is related to the press, which is related to the that heard, and which is related to the expression, and which is related to the speak, heard, press, and what is the next one? That is expression. No law can be made for that purpose. No restriction can be imposed by the administrative authority, executives, or Congress have no power to make any law. This is very clear. Now, one thing is very clear. After try to understand all these words, you will be able, whenever one will ask the what is the First Amendment of USA Constitution, point wise you will say the Congress has no power to impose any restriction on the free speech and expression. This is the one. The second point is the speak without the, that is a speech is a liberty. It is a liberty of individual to speech, to express. And that liberty has been given by the nature, recognized by the constitution makers in the American constitution. It means it is a natural aspect of everyone to speech and to speak. To say something, either by indication or by express provision. Indication also comes within this purview of speech, and I speak. That is the point. And another, it is linked with, the press is linked with speech and expression, not speak. Speech and expression. The speech and press commonly called the expression. Clear? There should not be any kind of doubt. Whenever you will write something, then the question, again question, as I have said that. These questions which say that why this kind of absolute freedom has given by the constitution framers of the United States of America to the citizen of that country. Why? What was the reason? Whereas it has not been given by any country to the citizen of their country. And absolutely it has been given in the America. The first reason of this aspect which says that it is the ideology, and that is the contribution of the person of America, who are they who have contributed, who have demanded, why this was given later on, why it has not been given the in the beginning. They were the jurist, they were the philosopher, and they were the judges, and they were the freedom fighters, and they were, there was the opinion of the people. They have demanded that there should be the natural right in the constitution. It should be recognized by the constitution makers by incorporating it, inserting it in the constitution, to give or to recognize, to give the special kind of liberty to the people of India. This was the first reason. The clear aspect of this analysis says or emphasized on the ideology of right thinking people of the Great Britain. Because if you will see the quotation relating to the first amendment of Jefferson, the father of the national movement, and gave the new direction, what he said about this, the why this absolute liberty has been given to the people of the United States of America by the constitution, this is a question. Answer of this question, that there was the opinion of the jurists, the philosophers, right-thinking people, and the demand of the public, number one. And this point I am just supporting by citing the quotation and the observation of Jefferson, what he said about it. Jefferson said that our liberty depends on the freedom of press. Our liberty depends on the freedom of press, point number one. And the statement of the Jefferson about the press, why this absolute power, the absolute right has been as a liberty has been given to the people of United States of America. In support of this argument, in support of this contention, I'm just quoting the statement or the observation given by the Jefferson, that he said that our liberty depends on the freedom of press. Second point, and that cannot be limited without being lost. That cannot be limited. Jefferson, who was one of the very wise men contributed lot to frame the constitution and the contribution for the national movement. He said that it cannot be limited without being lost. It means absolute right, absolute liberty requires to be given to the people of United States of America. This was the reason and supporting by, and it has supported by the Jefferson. Second reason. First reason you have seen, that ideology of jurists, philosophers, right thinking people, demand of the public of that country. And you have quoted the observation of Jefferson. Second reason is that the press is also essential for economic affairs, business, trade. As yesterday you have seen, the one of the aspect laid down by the Indian Supreme Court in 2020 related to the Article 19(1)(g), which is related to the business and trade in India. And press is very essential for the business, for the commercial affairs. And the top variety, top the in the top affairs of the state, and in the primary affairs of the state is of the USA is to earn and to collect the revenue in the interest of the state for development, for the development of that country. This is the top function of the state of United States of America. Therefore, unless there will not be any free press, the commercial activities and the business activities and activities related to the trade will not be free flow from one place to another place, because it requires to get the information by the businessmen as well as by the consumers who are interested to buy the goods. That is another reason. And third reason is that, as we know, that the free press is also essential for the education, for the knowledge, and for the knowledge of the that to restrict the unwanted things in a particular area. After this, it has been given the indication, but after this I will come again. Please don't leave this one, because unless I will not take the 1.5 hours class, it cannot be said that we have taught something. The one aspect you have seen, that is related to the language of the First Amendment. Second, you have seen the reasons why this absolute liberty has been given. And third, you have seen the who has drafted, why it was drafted, why it has left in the first stage to incorporate in the constitution later, what was the need. These you have seen. Now there is some restriction, and these restrictions has imposed by making the law by the Congress of USA to impose some indirect restriction, not direct restriction, as the restriction has given in the Constitution of India under 19(2). There you have seen, there are some words, and these words under this one, 19, if you will search, these are not there in American Constitution, but indirectly they made some laws. For example, if you will see, there is a law of 1778 related to the Sedition Act, and Sedition Act whenever there will be the criticism of the policy of the organ of the state. I'm talking about the USA. And that person can be restrained, that person can be detained under the certain provisions of that law, as amended in the 1918, also 1778, from very beginning, law was there, Sedition Act. And the restriction indirectly imposed on the speech and expression. By imposing the sedition, it is a very serious offense. Punishment is also very serious. And this has challenged, I will discuss this 19.2, the points relating to this one, and the 1798, leading that Sedition Act provisions are there, 1798 of the USA. And press under attack. If you will see, a heading can be given that criticism of this attitude or the function of the executive in USA relating to the free press. Constitution provides the free press. Constitution says that it is a liberty. Jefferson also says that this is the free press is the liberty depends on the freedom of the press. And a liberty cannot be protected unless there will not be the free press. It cannot be protected. This is the observation of the Jefferson. And the reason is very clear that because of the demand of the people, because of the education, because of the business, because of the economic affairs, because of the commerce, which relate to the other countries, because of the information, a absolute liberty has been given by the constitution makers. But the point is the criticism of the affairs of the executive or administrator, or indirectly you can say the government of USA relating to this aspect. Therefore, there is a Sedition Act and various times some restriction which is imposed on the newspaper, like the New York Times and some Pentagon papers, restriction has imposed and limit the liberty of publication and their ideologies. That was challenged before the Supreme Court on the ground of the violation of the First Amendment of the Constitution. But the Supreme Court has laid down certain principles. If you will see, there are cases before 1971 also. The famous case is there, the New York Times Company versus United States of America of 1971. And in that case, the false, scandalous, malicious writing was there against the government by the New York Times. And restriction has imposed by the government on the paper, and detaining action has been taken against the editors, and it has challenged that it is in violation of the First Amendment of the Constitution, which gives the absolute liberty, absolute freedom of press, because freedom is closely linked to the speech and expression, and commonly the expression and the press commonly called speech and the press commonly called the part of expression. There is the provision under that First Amendment of the Constitution. Then there was the challenge that action of the government is unconstitutional. But court has held that this is the malicious publication. Malicious publication means intentionally, if any paper, suppose we'll publish the any malicious statement, or in common sense you can say that defamatory statement, it cannot be said that by publishing that one, if the any restriction shall be imposed by the administrative authorities or the executive wing or organ of the particular country, that absolute freedom has been restricted. It cannot be said. Supreme Court. Why? Because it is a malicious. It is a intentional. This act of the any person cannot be permitted by the law, provision of the law. The language should be the civilized language, and there should be the criticism, of course, but malicious should not be there. Defamatory should not be there. If you will see the 9 words under the 19.2, we will discuss later on. There is one word, the defamation. As I have indicated in the first semester also, there is a still debate in India to remove this and to amend the defamation from the constitution, from the Indian Penal Code. There is a debate, and a committee has constituted to review the whole provision of the Indian Penal Code. And if you will search, they have displayed some questions, 33 questions. And one question has 4 and 5 parts. Give the suggestion what provision should be deleted, what should be incorporated, and what should be the new provisions. In the IPC, committee has been constituted, they are working. And very soon, they will submit the report to the Home Ministry, and then there is a proposal to amend the Indian Penal Code. And one of the point is there related to the defamation. Still, it is a crime. Unless it will not be deleted or repealed, and there will be the ground for that that purpose. Therefore, in this case, and if false, scandalous, the malicious statement, false, if there will be the test, is the false. If false statement shall be published, that it shows that it is a malicious intention of the publisher. Only test is there. It should not be false. It should be true. Words should be as it is available in the document. There should be documentary proof. Then that can be published. But there is some other restriction. If any matter is going to be investigated, it cannot be published. If the court has prohibited to publish,